गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे इज माई वीडियो लेसन इज ऑन सॉल्यूशन पार्ट 5 एंड सब टॉपिक इज कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी इन दैट डिप्रेशन इन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट. सो फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड नो द मीनिंग ऑफ डिप्रेशन एंड फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डिप्रेशन मीन्स टू डिक्रीज. And freezing point, you well know, freezing point, a liquid freezes at certain temperature, the temperature is called freezing point. It is also called melting point and freezing point, both are same. And friends, you know, at freezing point, substance exists in both phase. This is liquid and solid. So you can say there is equilibrium in between solid and liquid at its freezing point. Suppose you take an example of water. So water freezes at 0 degree Celsius. That means at 0 degree Celsius there is equilibrium, or you can say dynamic equilibrium, in between ice and liquid water, right? Or in term of vapor pressure, the vapor pressure of ice is equal to vapor pressure of water at freezing point. Now we can define freezing point by taking very less time. You see, freezing point of a substance is the temperature at which the solid and liquid forms of the substance are in equilibrium, and you can represent in this way, solid and liquid, it is in dynamic equilibrium. Or in term of vapor pressure, you can write, at freezing point the vapor pressure of solid and liquid have same vapor pressure. Friends, you know, if we draw a graph between temperature and vapor pressure, suppose this is the melting point of a substance, say H2O. At this point, say it is 0 degree Celsius. At this point, water exists in both form, liquid as well as in solid, right? As we decrease the temperature of this substance, that means less than 0 degree Celsius, so definitely its vapor pressure decreases and decreases like that. You can say it freezes and here it is in the form of solid only. But curves come like that. If you decrease the temperature less than 0 degree, then vapor pressure decreases and curves come like that. This is the curve of frozen solvent, right? Now we see in graph. Here this is a graph. This is a curve of frozen solvent, and x-axis represent the temperature axis, and y-axis vapor pressure. Now suppose solvent is there, it is in liquid form and it has some vapor pressure. Now decreasing the temperature, its vapor pressure decreases, and it comes at this temperature, and we represent this temperature T degree F, F for freezing. Now friends, suppose non-volatile solute is added in solvent, then definitely vapor pressure decreases, and this is the vapor pressure of solution containing non-volatile solute. After decreasing temperature of solution, its vapor pressure also decreases and it reaches the curve, it touches the curve of frozen solvent at this temperature Tf. So friends, you know Tf is less than T degree F. So here we observe there is depression in freezing point. Suppose water freezes at 0 degree Celsius after adding some non-volatile solute, say NaCl. If you add NaCl, so its melting point decreases by 0 degree Celsius. So this depression depends on number of solute particle. So depression in freezing point, it's very simple, you can say this is directly proportional to molality of solution, molality of solution. Or in similar way, elevation in boiling point, you have seen delta Tf is equal to Kfm, where Kf is constant, proportionality constant, constant known as depression in off freezing point constant, or this is molal depression constant, molal depression constant. Okay. We can expand this equation in term of mass of solute, molar mass of solute and mass of solvent to solve the numerical problem. Delta Tf is equal to Kf Wb upon Mb into 1000 upon Wa. So friends, you remember this relation because it is very important. And suppose one quantity is unknown, then you can easily find with the help of this equation. And Kf value is given in examination CBSE board, and in case of water you may remember it 1.86, right? It's a SI unit, right? Okay, you should keep in mind the unit also, and you can calculate the unit, but you always remember Kelvin kg per mole. Okay, well friends, next colligative property is osmotic pressure. It is represented by pi. Now before explaining osmotic pressure, I would like to explain osmosis. Osmosis. So in short time, first you see the definition of osmosis. The spontaneous flow of solvent, molecule from the solvent to the solution, or from a less concentrated solution to more concentrated solution through a semi-permeable membrane is called osmosis. That means you think इफ देयर इज सॉल्यूशन एंड सॉल्वेंट एंड बी सेपरेट दिस टू लिक्विड्स मीन्स सॉल्यूशन और सॉल्वेंट बाय मीन्स ऑफ सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन देन देयर इज ए स्पॉन्टेनियस फ्लो ऑफ सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल टू सॉल्यूशन थ्रू सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन राइट रफली यू थिंक इट नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन सो इन शॉर्ट यू नो सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन ए मेम्ब्रेन दैट अलाउज ओनली सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल टू पास थ्रू इट बिकॉज इट्स पोर एक्चुअली सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन इज पोरस एंड पोर इज सो स्मॉल सो दैट इट कैन अलाउ ओनली सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल नॉट सॉल्यूट मॉलिक्यूल और एज फॉर एग्जाम्पल सम नेचुरल सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन इज देयर वेजिटेबल्स मेम्ब्रेन एक्ट्स एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन एनिमल मेम्ब्रेन्स ऑल्सो पिग्स ब्लैडर ऑल्सो एक्ट्स एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन सम आर्टिफिशियल सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन इज देयर पार्चमेंट पेपर एक्ट्स एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन सेलोफेन एक्ट्स एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन कॉपर फेरोसाइनाइड एक्ट एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन सिलिकेट ऑफ आयरन एक्ट्स एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन सेल्यूलोस एस्टेट एक्ट्स एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन सो फ्रेंड्स आई थिंक यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन एंड ऑस्मोसिस यू कैन सी द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्मोसिस विथ अनदर एग्जाम्पल एज आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड इट इट्स अ यू नो एग ये एग दिस एग द आउटर कवर इज रिमूव्ड बाय पुटिंग एग इन HCl देन यू विल गेट द थिनर मेम्ब्रेन अराउंड एग वन एग इज डिप्ड इन वाटर एंड अनदर एग इज डिप्ड इन NaCl सॉल्यूशन सो इन फर्स्ट केस एग इन वाटर स्वेल्स इट्स साइज एक्सपेंड्स इट इज ड्यू टू ऑस्मोसिस बिकॉज मेम्ब्रेन एक्ट्स एज सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन एंड हियर द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ एल्बुमिन यू कैन से एल्बुमिन इज मोर देन वाटर सो ऑस्मोसिस टेक्स प्लेस सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल्स वाटर इंटर्स इन एग्स एंड सो ऑन इट्स स्वेल्स बट एग पुट इन NaCl सॉल्यूशन इज कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड सॉल्यूशन मोर देन एग एल्बुमिन सो प्रोसेस इज रिवर्स मॉलिक्यूल्स फ्रॉम एग कम्स आउट in solution and as a result the egg shrinks it is due to osmosis right and second now we see osmotic pressure you know here in next figure you see okay in this container solvent is there and here solution and it is separated through semi permeable membrane So as per definition, osmosis takes place. Solvent molecules passes through SPM to solution. It is due to high vapor pressure of solvent than solution, low vapor pressure. Right? That is the reason. Okay. So here you see atmospheric pressure is there. Here atmospheric pressure. एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर, हियर ऑल्सो एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर. नाउ इफ वी अप्लाई सम एक्सटर्नल प्रेशर ऑन इट, देन वॉट हैपन्स? यू आर अप्लाइंग सम एक्सटर्नल प्रेशर, देन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्मोसिस इज स्टॉप्ड, राइट? सो द प्रेशर दैट स्टॉप्स द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्मोसिस इज कॉल्ड ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. सपोज पाई अमाउंट ऑफ प्रेशर इज अप्लाइड ऑन दिस सॉल्यूशन एंड द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्मोसिस स्टॉप्स, सो दिस प्रेशर इज कॉल्ड ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. हियर इन नेक्स्ट फिगर यू सी कि वन इन्वर्टेड थिसल फनेल इज पुट इन टब एंड हियर सॉल्वेंट एंड दिस इज सॉल्यूशन एंड माउथ इज कवर्ड विथ सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन. सो डेफिनेटली ऑस्मोसिस टेक्स प्लेस, सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल्स इंटर इन थिसल फनेल एंड द लेवल rises and ultimately it stops at a certain limit. Why? Because pressure due to this column, pressure is equal to how much? Pressure is equal to h rho g, where h is height of the column, rho is density of liquid or solution, and g is acceleration due to gravity. So if this pressure is equal to osmotic pressure, then the process of osmosis is stopped. Okay friends, I think you know the meaning of osmotic pressure, or you can define osmotic pressure in this way: the pressure required to just stop the process of osmosis is called osmotic pressure. And osmotic pressure pi is directly proportional to concentration of solution in molarity at particular temperature. So pi is directly proportional to Ct, where temperature in Kelvin and C is concentration, or pi is equal to RCt, or you can write pi equal to CRT, where C is concentration, R is gas constant, right? So friends, you remember this equation, it's very important, and you can expand this relation in this way: pi is equal to C concentration, means number of moles of definitely solute, upon volume in liter. Because molarity is concerned in this equation, because temperature is fixed at a particular temperature, RT. Or you can expand N, this is WB upon MB, and V in liter. You always remember volume is in liter, RT. So this is the equation to solve numerical problem regarding osmotic pressure. It's very important, and I think you can. Friends, you see here, if we write pressure by P, then it is PV equal to nRT. It's a ideal gas equation, right? So it is similar to ideal gas equation. Okay friends, now my next point is reverse osmosis. So a student, you know, if the process of osmosis is taking place, you see in this figure, ki here solvent and here solution, and solution and solvent is separated by means of semi-permeable membrane. So naturally vapor pressure of solvent is more than solution, so osmosis takes place from solvent to solution. But if we apply pressure at solution side and this pressure is more than osmotic pressure, if pressure is equal to osmotic pressure, then process of osmosis is stopped. But if pressure is more than osmotic pressure, then the process of osmosis gets reversed. That means solvent molecules from solution passes to solvent. So on this solution containing some dissolved salt is purified. That means saline water can be changed into drinking water. It's very important appliance nowadays, that is RO plant. It is seen in almost each and every homes. RO plant is there and it is based on the reverse osmosis. Okay friends, so you know reverse osmosis. And next one is some terminology is there. So we will see. Isotonic solution. Iso means equal. Tonic means it is related to osmotic pressure. Isotonic solution. Two solutions having same osmotic pressure is called isotonic solution. If two isotonic solutions are separated by means of semi-permeable membrane, then no osmosis takes place because vapor pressure of both the solution is same. So no osmosis is there. Now one very important example is there. 0.9% solution of pure NaCl is isotonic with human red blood cell. That means the solution cell shape concentration is equal to 0.9% solution of pure NaCl, right? And next one is hypotonic solution. A solution of pure NaCl whose concentration is less than 0.9% mass by volume. This is called hypotonic solution. And hypertonic solution, a solution of pure NaCl whose concentration is more than 0.9% mass by volume. Friends, you know, you tell me one question is there. Ki if a solution whose concentration is more, this one more concentration, and this is less concentration, which having more osmotic pressure. So friends, you know, pi is directly proportional to C. So if concentration is more, then osmotic pressure is more. You can think it by this figure also. It's a previous figure, you know. Suppose this is solvent and this is more concentrated solution. That means vapor pressure is low, too much low. So you have to apply more pressure, and more pressure, that means osmotic pressure to stop the process of osmosis. If less concentrated solution, that means vapor pressure is almost similar to solvent, so very less pressure is required to stop the process of osmosis. So you always remember ए कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड सॉल्यूशन हैविंग मोर ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. राइट फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट आरबीसी, रेड ब्लड सेल. सो इन रेड ब्लड सेल यू नो द सलाइन वाटर और इंटरवेनस इंजेक्शन हुज कंसेंट्रेशन शुड बी 0.9% मास वाई वॉल्यूम NaCl. Otherwise, what happen? This is your RBC and this is cell sap of RBC, and cell wall acts as semi-permeable membrane. Suppose a solution is entered in blood and whose concentration is more than 0.9%, then what happen? Osmosis takes place from RBC to outer solution, and in this situation the cell shrink. But if solution is less than 0.9%, then what happens? Osmosis takes place from outer solution, less concentrated solution, to more concentrated solution, and in this case the RBC swells and ultimately burst. So this is the application. Now these are the four colligative properties. We will see numerical problem in next video related to elevation in boiling point and depression in freezing point, osmotic pressure. Right? Okay, thank you very much.